I don't know where to look. What do you think to this, guys? This is a I'm having a play actually. Adrian Salisbury here from the Pro Video Academy here on the Pro Video Made Easy group. I'm just having a play around over here because I've just discovered I've been getting ready for a interview tomorrow with Glenn from Ecamm. Really excited about that. But I've had to just go through and double check that I know what I'm doing with interviewing. And as part of the process, I spotted that you can use your phone and bring it in as a webcam in here. Now, I'm just having a play with this, and it's ever so glitchy. It just seems that every now and again it will just cut off and I get a black window. So if one of these cuts out in a minute, that's what's going on with it. But that aside, I thought this gives me the opportunity in a live to literally put these three cameras side by side and have a look at the comparison. So, should we have a look at one at a time? Let me double check which is right. This is I've only got small thumbnails down here. There, I'll hide these things. So, at the minute, this is our phone. All right, so. There's the picture coming through from the phone. Looks reasonable when I look at the screen on the phone here, but when I'm looking at it coming through here on the feed, it's not good. And what's happening here? And it's gone. There we go. Wonderful. Told you it was glitchy. The phone is out of action. In fact, while I'm just flicking over to the webcam, let's just wipe this up and see if I can load the thing back up again. What I was going to say is that you get this. Because of the different frame rates, we get this banding going on because, here we go, we're back in. You can see that kind of weird banding going on. That's because, and I don't know that I can change the setting on this, that's because of the frame rate as it's coming through on the camera here. I don't think I can change that on my phone without, well, no, I don't in this, so there's no settings in that. So that's an interesting one to have a look at. So that's the phone. That is our webcam view coming through. This is in the top of my brand new MacBook Pro, 15 inch. So, you know, this ought to be a decent camera coming through in this. I have made sure and I've wiped that screen to make sure that's not mucky. Again, you know, it ain't great. And actually, the fact that my desk is a little bit wobbly here because it's one of these ones that I can raise up and lower down. So it doesn't take much to knock this. So that's not cool in itself. But then, yeah, we flick that off and I can come over and I can turn on the camera. And all of a sudden, is this not in a different league? This is what I bang on about all day long, is the difference in the quality that you can get with having these different setups. And do you know what it makes me realize as I'm just fiddling around and playing on this? I'm looking at these different pictures coming through on here. I'll turn these off because that's just getting confusing. I'm looking at my phone, I'm looking at my webcam, and I look at the camera and I think, do you know what? If this is what I see when I go live, then I look awful in that picture. And I'd be very reluctant to go live actually because that doesn't excite me. The thought of me putting myself out looking like that. Or even that, yeah, this is one of your blockages for going live and acting on video, is because you don't think you look good. And honestly, if that's what I'm looking at, then I don't think I'm looking good on that either. But when I show up on this and I have people say to me, "Wow, you look so good on your videos," doesn't half make a difference. Now that you can just see the corner of my phone here at the bottom of this screen, don't worry about that. And I am very conscious that, but I am really borderline on having the minimum amount of internet to be able to use my camera like this or use anything to upload. I think he can say it's about, ideally, it's about 6 megs as an upload. We'll find out tomorrow. We're going to have a good chat with Glenn. But I think it's about 6 megs, 4 to 6 megs, it probably is as an upload. And that's about what I get. And the kids are in the house at the minute, and they're probably watching a film and streaming that. So what you're seeing now is not it at its best. But yeah, one last time, let's just pop these up and show you these. And what a great feature inside Ecamm that it lets me do this. So Maybe I don't put the tags up and you can spot which one's which. The webcam I'm just covering up now, the phone I'm covering up now, and then the other one's the camera. But yeah, fun little comparison. I'm playing around with it over here, and I thought, why don't I just do a quick live and let you have a look at that, see what you think to the comparison. Would that make you want to change? So we're going to be doing a live tomorrow, 5 p.m. in the UK. The times are all over here. I'll just put a link in the description to make sure you can find it. Whether you join in from one of the groups or from the page, we're going to be broadcasting it out on the page so you can share it with the people, you can tag them, let them know to come over and have a look. Ecamm is a fantastic bit of software that I use for all of my videos. It's the first time I've done an interview in it, so that's a little bit scary. But I'm just starting off what I want to be a weekly Facebook Live show, and I'm bringing in it's not all going to be me talking about video. I am bringing in people because I'm conscious that typically my customer is someone who's got, they're building an online business, they've got a course, they've got a membership site, and they need to make videos. And as you can see here, I'm a strong believer that quality really does make a difference. When we're doing live streaming, the difference of using your phone and then stepping up to this, the fact that I can put like this branding and things on, I can put images in, I can put videos on, I could actually do a slideshow like a webinar from within Ecamm here. So I'm starting this off and I thought, who better to come and join me on the first week, the first show, than to get Glenn to come over from Ecamm. So I'm really pleased that he was up for it, and it's going to be a great show tomorrow. And then we've got different people coming in just to talk about general online business. I've got people who are going to be helping us look at Facebook ads, doing this live stuff, whether you use a Facebook page or a group. I've got guys that are going to come on and talk to us about messenger bots and how you can use those in this kind of stuff. Others just on general getting going, launching a business, this kind of thing. So, yeah. And my brand, what I'm doing is, the pro video made easy. That's what I'm all about, is getting you so that you can have video like this, nice and easy, without all the hassle. But yeah, all the other stuff along with it, I would like to help you with too. So really excited about that. Looking forward to this show tomorrow. And why don't you come and join us? All right, so I hope you've enjoyed that. I'm just playing around with stuff over here, but why not share it and show you and let you have a look at how these work. And once again, look, out of interest, there you go, my phone input has gone again. So I will be getting back to them on that. Okay, thanks, guys. See you tomorrow.